Student, this is Niharika from St. Joseph's Convent School. Today I am going to teach you that force and pressure of 8th class part 3. As I have taught you in the other two parts, that up to pressure, but here I am going to teach today that pressure exerted by the liquids. Now let's see what is the pressure exerted by the liquids. So before that I will give you some examples, children. Whenever you are playing Holi, maybe you have seen that balloons you have seen, that you have taken these balloons like this. But whenever there is a tap is there, water is coming out, that on that tap, if you will put this balloon, means after some time, you can see that the balloon will like this. Why this is? Because this is the balloon. So because due to this pressure of the water only, that balloon will become like this. Means here, from this experiment, here it is proved that water exerts some pressure inside the balloon, so that balloon is bulged. So due to this water pressure only, that balloon shape is bulging shape. So now we will read about that the instrument with which you can measure this water pressure, and what are the characteristics of the water pressure, and what are the consequences of the water pressure, and the scientist who had given this laws about this laws. So now the device is the manometer. So it will ask in your exam that what is manometer. That manometer is the device to measure water pressure. With the help of this instrument, we can measure the water pressure. Now we will see about the characteristics of the water pressure characteristics. Now one by one, let's understand. So now student, we will read about the characteristics of the liquid pressure. So here I have written the characteristics. Now one by one I will explain you. Here I have written the first characteristics, that liquid exerts pressure on the walls of the container. I will show you. Suppose this is the container, bachcho. Suppose this is the container. So here liquids are there. So whatever liquid is there, it will exert pressure inside the on the container. Means here it is the walls of the container. That liquid exerts pressure on the walls of the container. Everywhere that liquid exerts the pressure. Now the second one, what I have written, that is the pressure is directly proportional to the density of the liquid. Means suppose you have taken here, this is the water you have taken. In another container, you have taken the oil, castor oil or any oil you have taken. So between these two liquids, pressure is directly proportional to the density of the liquid. Means here, whatever the pressure is exerted by the water is less than the pressure exerted by the oil, because water is less denser than oil, or you can say that oil is more denser than water. Means oil exerts more pressure on this container and water exerts less pressure as compared to the oil. Now go to the third point, children. That is the pressure increases due to depth. Directly proportional, means it increases on the as depth increases. Now see, suppose one container is that much and liquids are like this here, and another container is that much and liquids are like this here. So if depth increases, here the depth is that much, here the depth is that much. So in these two cases, here the liquid pressure is more, because as height is more, as height or depth increases, the pressure of the liquid increases. Now go to the third point, children. That is the liquid pressure exerts same pressure in all directions at all points lying at a given depth inside the liquid. You have to understand it clearly. Suppose here one container is there and your liquid is there. So whatever the points I have given you, I will show you clearly. Suppose these are the points. So why I have given like this? Because this is based upon this point. Exert same pressure in all direction at all points. At all points lying at a given depth. Means suppose you are taking, as I told that at depth increases, pressure increases. But if I will take this layer first, suppose I will take this layer, means all the points are this one, the all the points. Means whatever the pressure exerted by the liquid, it is same in this point, this point, this point, this point, and this point. But it is more in this level. It is and more in this level. It is less in this level. But all the pressure in this level, what are the points are there? That is the same pressure exerted in all direction. That is the difference between the this point and this point. Means in one level, what are the points are there? The pressure is same from all directions. So now next property, children, that it seeks its own level. It means liquid seeks its own level irrespective of shape, size, and area of container. That means what? Any type of container you take, maybe bottle, maybe glass, whatever you are taking, then if you see that this is the one type of container, that is the long one you have taken. Another type of container like this, you suppose you have taken. And whatever the water you are putting here, you can see that the upper level is like this. This is straight line, it will come. And everywhere it is a rectangular shape. The same liquid if you will pour into that shape. So whatever it is there, it takes all the shape. Like this it will take. But also whenever you will see that, the upper level is that much only. That means the liquid seeks its own level. Means irrespective of the area. Here the area of cross section is more. Here the shape is more. Then also as it is the plane level, this is also the plane level. Means that water, the property of water is, it seeks its own level. Now children, as I told before that, one scientist had given this theory, name is Blaise Pascal. B-L-A-I-S-E, Blaise Pascal. According to his name, the law's name is, that is the Pascal's law. So what he said about this liquid pressure, now see. He told that suppose this is the one of the balloon, it is attached. Here one balloon is attached. So this is the balloon, it is attached. And in that balloon some holes are there. Some holes are there. And here one piston is there and you are applying the pressure that on that piston. And remember that it is the confined liquid. So what do you mean by confined, children? That there must be some boundary, not the flowing water. Confined means inside a container. Any type, any shape of the container or any balloon here I have taken. In that balloon I have taken some water. So every type, confined means it is inside. Inside any container or it is boundary is there. So that liquid must be confined. What is the first condition is the liquid must be confined. The liquid is a confined liquid. Confined liquid. First condition. Second one, you are applying a pressure and the liquid is incompressible. Compressible means whatever the volume of the liquid you are taking, that volume must be same. Incompressible liquid. That is the second condition. So what happened? What he, as he had taken, what it had done? Whenever the force is applied, means it is the piston, he applied the force upside, he pressed that piston. Whenever he pressed the piston, water inside the balloon, that or balloon or you can take anything, that water is coming out like this. Means in the same pressure. And whatever the water is coming, that is in the same streamline it is coming. Means from the experiment what he understood, that whatever the shape of the container and whatever the liquid inside it, as it is pressed by the piston over it, so the pressure is transmitted inside that container in the same direction and same pressure is transmitted. That is told by the Pascal. Means what it is there? That if pressure is applied on a confined liquid, which is an incompressible one, then the pressure transmitted the pressure transmitted, same pressure is same in all directions. And another one is the undiminished. Undiminished means what? That pressure does not finishes. Undiminished, whatever the liquid inside it, up to the finishing of the liquid, that pressure is exerts, and whenever you are pressing it, means that same pressure up to you are applying that one, it is undiminished working on that liquid. So you can write in the say one line, that is the, as it is a definition, from the definition only I have broke down that one point wise, but you have to write this definition in one line. What is that one? That whenever pressure is applied on a liquid, on a which liquid? On a confined liquid, confined and incompressible liquid, then pressure is transmitted, then same pressure is transmitted in undirections and undiminished. That is the definition of the Pascal's law. Now children, let's read about the consequences of the liquid process. Means what? That is the three consequences I have written here, many of them, but three I have written here. That walls of the dams made thicker. These sea divers wear special suit. Water supply tanks kept at the roof. These three maybe you have felt in your day-to-day life. Then also again I want to say that one, that is dams you have to made the thicker, because many a large quantity of water is there. Like this, deep sea divers have to go to the down of the sea, so they have to wear a special suit. Like this, water supply tanks, it is the common example. You have seen that always it is put in the kept up the roof only. So why this? If questions will ask, you have to write that answer. As I have explained before, that always water pressure is directly proportional to the depth of the liquid. Means if depth increases, pressure increases. Depth decreases, pressure decreases. So in all these cases, the depth is increases. So pressure is the depth. It is the, yes, depth increases. So pressure, it is increases. That's why to withstand with the greater pressure, we have made like this. So this is our today's topic, children. Read your chapter, go through your book, then only again the next part I will tell about the pressure exerted by the gases. Thank you children for today.